Stop. 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 Come on, stop. Oh, my favorite glasses. Greasy now in my chicken nuggets.
Oh, no. I was just joking around. But now I've dirtied Scott's glasses and worse, Scott's nuggets. I'm a monster.
It'll be okay, Kevin.
I think there's a lesson here, guys.
Is it about the nuggets?
Not exactly. It's about teasing. I know it can be meant in good fun, but we should be careful not to cross the line into bullying or harassment. Like when one person is singled out, it keeps going on after the person has asked for it to stop, or it's based on something out of the person's control, like race, gender, or ability, or especially if it involves touching someone without their consent.
Doesn't consent mean getting voluntary permission before doing any kind of, you know, sexual stuff?
Yes, but consent also applies to any other kind of physical contact. We should check before touching someone's hair or clothes or even giving them a hug. And while it might seem funny or flirty to poke someone, snap their bra, or pull down their pants, it is not a healthy way to show somebody you like them. It could really be embarrassing or hurtful to them and get you in serious trouble. You wouldn't want someone poking or grabbing you without permission. You shouldn't do it to another person.
Definitely. But what should I do if me or one of my friends is being harassed, teased, or touched without permission?
Talk to a trusted adult, like a parent, teacher, or counselor who can help you put a stop to the behavior. If the first adult you talk to can't help, keep reaching out until you find someone who can.
The bottom line is, even if you are being playful, teasing can hurt. So if someone asks you to stop, then stop. And always make sure you ask before touching another person in any way.
You're right. And thanks. Sorry again about your glasses, Scott. And to prove that I'm really sorry, I'm going to dirty my own face.
You could have just cleaned off my glasses.
I know, but that's not my style.